them down a little bit more, but the three players are going to be moving through B main at the same time. Not sure if CTix is going to be... Oh, sorry, Mushroom is going to be ready.
Yeah, Mushroom. Holding on the angle, Pool Tap falls, so does Pool Tap gets a kill, so does Wannafly, and they are going to be able to get in towards the site right now as Ginny, with the Lurk, able to get bring down Mushroom, so it's down to a 4 versus 3. As the B side is completely open, this is retake situation from the side of Myth.
Oh yeah, and they got three players stacked up here, but they do not have the numerical advantage, and oh no, Wannafly, he's going to be able to catch out Nugen, and straight away, Boom Baroppa not going to have a much of a chance there. D-Lofam, varying degrees of success, but of course that was in the group stages, but now we are going to see that the rotation coming out here to A main, they're trying to keep as many of these long angles as possible. They don't want to get stuck up in close quarters. A short is looking absolutely hazardous, but Boom Baroppa, he's using the dark cover to his advantage as he's gonna just going to be hiding out there, but it's only going to be lasting for so long. He's going to get absolutely everyone looking at him, and he's going to get taken out straight away.
Yeah, and we do see PTC already trying to clear the site. He only has a ghost, so he has to watch out. He clears under heaven, but no, Pool Tap will hold his ground. Gets the kill, Konga Red with the Bulldog, as well as Ascetics with the Vandal will be able to bring down two of the players, and that just leaves only the Lil Family, as well as the Sova left remaining for this retake. 2 versus 4 with only Classics. Doesn't look doable.
No, I think at the very most, they're just going to be going for any potential exit kills that are going to be presented to them, the saving. Well, I mean, they could really try and prevent the extra money and the ult point. But, of course, if they can get an exit frag, I think that is going to be worth a whole lot more, as it's going to be a weapon that almost certainly these guys are not going to upgrade in the third round.
Yeah, looks like, AAA already leaving the site, knowing that, you know, the time is of the essence. They might go try and go for a defuse, but we do already have Ginny just holding the angle, making sure they cannot defuse in time. And they should not be able to get this as the time OX to Mushroom will go on along with the spike.
But there's no one here to take advantage of this. But now look at the space being created by PTC. He's going to get in on site looking for Congrid, or Boom Baroppa, sorry. And now it looks like his opposite number is going to be able to take him down.
That's going to be the site opened up there for AAA. They should be able to get the spike down, and they do have the numbers advantage for this retake. Of course, Konga Red took some damage, but definitely still alive and will be able to make a difference.
Well, now looks like they are just trying to gather a little bit more information here. Sova Arrow not going to yield too much, but they can kind of guess that there's going to be players in hell now as a result. But PTC, he's going to be able to take down Nugen. This is going to be an execute, but there's only going to be two players left. They are outnumbered at the moment. Two players all the way over by Tree. It's going to be absolutely devastating. Coming around the side to Generator, going to get taken down straight away. But now Pooh One Tap, his aim here is to not let them get out alive, as there's still going to be two of them. He's worried. He gets one. He might be able to get the clutch here, and he's actually able to clutch it out, and he will be able to get the defuse as well. Pooh One Tap coming up huge.
Definitely Myth, they have to throughout this tournament, as they do get some information towards mid. Spotted it with the cyber cam as you see, like we said, but Nugen with the judge able to get a kill and stop PTC in his tracks. That's all the damage that PTC will be doing, and it's going to be down to a 3 versus 4 somehow once again, as AAA is able to get that man advantage, but they have yet to commit to any single site.
Yeah, I mean, they did manage to take down D-Love Family. He was actually going to take that aggressive peek on A-Short, but it wasn't going to be that successful. Now, with that additional presence, it's actually forcing Boom Baroppa to get a little bit closer to so that he can get intel. They are a little bit worried, and you can see the other two players going to be rotating around to A, but the mind games coming out here from Attack All Around is they're going to be repositioning
left,
ever so slightly after the trade on B.
Yep, Attack All Around somehow always seems to play like they have observer vision. They seem to be able to make the call to push into the exact correct sites every single time, and right now they are marching in towards B, calling it their own, and the spike will go down. The rotations are just starting to go on. Myth just found out what they are missing here, and that is the A site.
Well, I think it can't be too bad of a thing here for Myth Attitude, given the fact that they only have the three players, and they'd rather stack up on one side and actually go for a 3v4 retake rather than split it up and then lose one player, and then they have to save. It's not really going to be that beneficial, but this time they will have a fighting chance. and if we saw anything else come out from the previous round, a 2v4 definitely possible, 3v4 even more.
Yeah, definitely. Nugent has an interesting crosshair, if you notice. It's a black dot, not something we see every day. Oh, SC takes through the wall, we're able to bring down Nugent, and that's going to sound a retreat from the side of Myth Attitude, as they will not attempt this once again. One time, maybe a miracle. Second time, definitely not going to be a pattern here from the side of AAA, as they will let the spike finish up the rest. Myth going to be down, but you can be easily overran. This is a very close corner that you are pretty much one and done.
Yeah, exactly. And I think, you know, we've seen some nice plays, I think, from Nugent in the previous series where he was able to get in the faces, but he's only got a Marshall here. And now it looks like the whole of attack all round, they're all going to be pushing in on site. Pooh wants that. He's going to go down first. But now Mushroom going to be following suit. It's going to be an absolute bloodbath, as there's not really going to be anything now they can do to stop this. And that broken by now going to be quite expensive here for Myth, as really, this is not going to be a winnable situation from the looks of things.
Yeah, Mushroom, he had the angle, he had the range, but somehow he just turned around at the wrong timing, and they just been able to overrun him inside the site. So AAA will get themselves 4 on the board. Myth still trying to claw themselves back. We do have Wannafly trying to maybe get some frags. He does get T-Lip D. And that just leaves the Omen left alive. Boomerappa trying to hold on to his Vandal, but Wannafly is hot on his heels.
Oh, and he is hunting right now, but not sure if he's going to be able to find out. Conquer Advent looks, Boomerappa, excuse me, but looks like he's going to be able to get the jump on him. Only a little
burst. That's going to give away that they are going to for a B execute. Can Mushroom hold on his own? He has an Odin Hunter's Fury trying to clear out the angles. He hasn't been able to land any of them soon, but D able to get a kill on this. Wannafly, Puan Tap as well. That's a kill, and that's going to be Mushroom killing off PTC with the Odin. Odin, the Odin is doing it. Gets the kill onto Genie as well, and finally it seems like Myth will be able to get a very clean round.
Oh, the Odin plays here, and it looks like the crossfire is really working wonders. The C-Dix, the last player left. He's got an aftershock. He gets no.
Saw it again now. AAA slightly running out of time. Boomerappa will be the last man standing against this. Can he hold on?
Oh my goodness, he is right next to them! He's gonna be walking right in the middle of three different guns there. PTC is gonna be able to catch him, and if only he had known. But yeah, I think, look at this. There's so much vision being obstructed here. If they're gonna be able to get the plant down, currently all gonna be locking it, as Concrete hiding out behind Generator. Only this presence around here on Heaven, this is gonna be a little bit narrow for the defense.
Yeah, PTC playing very cleverly. He knows that the enemy has an OD. He's not even gonna try playing under Heaven, as they're gonna start and push in. Oh, the Odin strikes again, getting a Q on towards Conger Red, but the time is running out. Mushroom, can he come up big once again? There is a couple of Cloudbursts trying to stall out time. The Odin gets the second kill. Can he get a third? Yes, he can. The Odin is making it work, but from the shadows, from hell, PTC able to get a Q on towards Mushroom. The plenty of success on this site, and Boomerappa will be the lone defender here. He gets one kill on towards PTC. That's a good start. He gets the second on towards Wannafly. Even better. Almost gets the third on towards Ginny. But way too much damage already sustained by him. And that's going to be leaving it to a 4 versus 3 situation at the moment, as Myth will be able to hold on for now. We have Dila Family pushing off aggressively. He might be able to catch off one off guard. He spots the spike as well, so he knows that they can focus right now on the side of A side, as AAA only has 2 members remaining.
Oh, but C-Tix, he does manage to get the spike again, but again, it's not looking too good. Only 2 players left here. And honestly, really good trade out from Boomerappa, able to take 2 for 1. It's definitely going to be on the cards. Now, there is still going to be a little bit of a challenge here. I think not really thinking they're going to be here, but no, he spots him out. He misses the collateral here, but Nugent still
towards A, but in the end, it is just the bait.
Yeah, after the camera got taken out there as well, and bottom mid, it's not going to allow them to have any more information. But look at the Rolling Thunder, not really affecting too much. Pooh, one tap is going to be able to take down a C-Dix straight away. He gets the second there onto PTC. Only 3 players left. Wannafly trying to even things up here as he moves up to market. But look at this. All of his teammates getting taken out here, but he's going to be able to at least...
Walls of Vandal so deadly here. One tap, buying some time as he's completely flashed through, and he's going to get scanned off there. And a C-Tix gets a kill on towards him as well. Still, oh, the fault line's gonna buy a little bit of time, but they are gonna push through. AAA wants this B site.
Oh, and now that's going to give opportunity for the Love family to rotate over here, but now with the dark cover, not going to have too much vision. PTC covering from B main already, much too forced to back all the way towards the boathouse, but he's still going to take down Wannafly. He's mowing down PTC as well. Odin plays all around here, as left. Now there's only going to be a little bit of presence. Mushtoon picks up the third here, and now looks like there's only going to be Ginny all the way here in market. She's all by herself. And the spike here is going to be all the way in the middle of B.
Yeah, it seems like Mushroom really wants to make me eat my words, because he has making...
And look at the positioning out coming out from the mid players. I think they are well aware of that. They're holding very long angles here. And Newgen's going to be able to take down Wannafly as not having too much luck. And PTC also going to be smarting here with only just a fraction of HP. Because if they keep enough of distance, it's still going to be two shots here from any of these sheriffs. Of course, they want to try and deal damage here to Myth. They're not expecting to win the round, but if they're able to make sure that they can't carry any of the guns to the next round, that will be the aim. But again, there's only going to be one round after this before they swap sides.
Yeah, like you said, it's not going to affect their economy too much, as we do see the push coming in. Dealer family trying to hold on. Is a PTC in the close range. Gets a Q under Dealer family. But Putep as well as Boomerappa both getting one apiece. Putep gets the second. The Odin spamming true. And it's just going to be left to side where you have LMG with 100 bullets just spamming right at you.
Yeah, but I love Mushtoom's play moving into the back of B and using the intel to, you know, offer the threat of the wall bang there. But now look at this, the push coming all the way here into market. They are going to be on B main as well, as they're going to get a number of sidelines. But this is still going to have significant rotations coming out. Poo on tap is going to get the better of his opposite number. It looks like Newgen is going to follow suit as well. They are going to still continue to push in. The one-way setup by Newgen might be quite effective at stalling them out here. They're going to be by the shed here. But look at this. Mushroom is going to come through the smoke here from spawn. A little bit of caution here for attack all around, as they're going to have to back up a little bit. Ginny, she's watching out here on the market side of things. Looking at the push coming, but it's not going to be easy. Ginny still manages to get the kills there onto Boomerappa and Mushroom. Well played.
Enemy down. Classic is pretty lethal close range. PTC able to strike down. Newgen Maputep will get the trade as well. 2v3. Myth does not have the control over the spike, as Acetix is holding on towards B main, and the Outdrone will get information that they are still hanging out around there. The spike is still left in the open in the market, and AAA can just play it rather slowly.
Yeah, so I'm not even sure if they want to actually go and get the spike, but this is giving time here for the rotation all the way through spawn, and looks like Wannafly is ready there for Poo One Tap. Now Congred is going to be continuing to lock down the zones. C-Tix watching here from the B stairs, but really not a whole lot going on, but the shots could still fall here. But looks like the La family is going to be able to reduce it down to 2v. He's going to have his vision obstructed a little bit here. Not going to be able to stop this push coming in here. But look at this. Ginny here from the spawn side of things going to be able to get one. PTC able to get in from the backside. Able to get a second. Now look at this. It's going to be dodgy there. But looks like Congred will be able to push through with the Spectre here. And going to be mowing down three of them in quick fashion.
AAA managed to win this round rather. Come up big, especially on these entry kills. Ginny might be able to get the kill on towards Poo One Tap. He walks into the crosshair, but Poo One Tap a little bit too fast for her. Acetix will be able to get the revenge done, but still, losing out your breach that early on is going to be very detrimental when you are trying to take the retake on those sites.
Oh, Acetix just banged his owl drone into the bars. They're not able to get through. I think he forgot that it's not exactly possible. But he's still going to be able to get the tank there onto Boomerappa. It's going to delay him from really wanting to lurk around there. But he did give himself away. So now it's going to be up to whether or not that bait is going to be bitten here. But currently it's still 4-4. But three players going to be stacked up here on the A side for attack all around. Might be able to repel this attack.
Congaret playing around the one-way smoke, while we do have PTC hiding behind the box on heaven, as Myth will try and enter towards the A side. Wannafly gets scanned out and gets spammed through the cyber cage. Boomerappa already inside Newgen, getting a kill on those Congaret, and that's gonna be AAA losing out on this side. One member left on their roster still alive, and I don't think this retake will be coming anytime soon.
Oh my goodness, and Myth, they have come to play for sure on Triple A's map, but CTX, he wants to deal damage. He's not going to give that free win away just like that. And he's actually looking to see, can he catch any others? But looks like after that initial one, he's going to count his lucky stars. He's actually just going to be hiding out. But now look at Newgen. He is on the hunt as well. Wants to really try and lock down this last player. CTX has been one of the players to really carry attack all around. but he's not able to get the second kill there. And now that's gonna...
But Hunger Red just drops it once again. It looks like Myth trying to push through mid, gets the kill on towards Ginny. That's gonna sound the push towards B, as everyone from the side of Myth will be making that push. PTC gets a kill on towards New Gen. That's gonna slow them down a little bit as they are rethinking their strategy.
Oh, that was unfortunate timing. The dark cover just expiring at the wrong moment there, and New Gen's gonna get punished for that. But I think with that, they did see that the movement was going into market, and you can see that PTC is starting to cover this angle here onto B main, but this is gonna be an attack on the A side. Currently, Congrat can't see all that much here in the dark cover, but he is lurking and waiting here for the right moment. They're gonna push onto site. Wanna Fly trades out here, but now this could be Congrat's chance to really make an impact, but he's gonna get spotted out by Mushtoo. He's gonna get the coverage onto Heaven's side. There is still going to be PTC trying to move in here from Tree.
Yeah, 2 versus 3. This retake possible, but definitely not in the favor of AAA as a CTX. Maybe if he gets the first entry kill, he's able to get things done here. But stalling a lot of time is this fault line as PTC gets one kill. God. Can he get a close second? No, he gets spammed through this wall from the side of Mushroom as it's down to 2 versus 1. CTX, can he come up huge here as Recon Vault will give the information. He's up on Heaven, hasn't dropped down, and time is almost running out. He goes down, gets a kill on his dealer family. Can he make this close? The timer is almost running out. He has literally 3 more seconds to get this kill and get the defuse. Mushroom playing fantastically, ring around the Rosie. He gets the headshot. Is there enough time? No, there is not. CTX has to abandon the site, not even going to try and on an eco.
Oh yes, and this is going to be very dicey for them. Now it looks like they are going to still try and open all the avenues as much as possible. Dark cover going to make it difficult here for the retake, but they are still trying to see what they can do. Currently he's going to obstruct over on B main, but they move in. CTX actually able to get the opening frag, and now look at this. Hunter's Fury is going to be unleashed here, able to catch out one of the players, but he's going to be expired pretty soon. One Fly is going to take a page out of Miss Book here and actually moving in here with the Bucky. But look at this, the trades now going to be very even, but there's not a lot of time remaining here. Only one player from Miss still going to be in it. Look at the acrobatics from Acetix, but unfortunately there's no time left here, but the defuse still going down. No, this super tight angle here being held by PTC, but it can get completely overrun by his opposite number. The right click not connecting here for New Gen.
Hunter's Fury as well providing some information as here comes the Neuro Theft. That's going to show everyone from the side of Myth where their opponent is as they are going to try and go for this retake. Spike goes down, 4 versus 5. They have the Operator on the side of PTC. Butterfly tries to get a couple of kills. The Aftershock not going to connect as 3 players are stuck on this Heaven area. Definitely a very difficult retake position to be in.
Yeah, the Dila family using all the utility there in Hell to really try and delay things as much as possible. I'm not even sure if Boom Barappa still has a Paranoia available. This could delay things, but they're all dropping down from Heaven side here. The CTX moving in from Tree. He's going to be able to pick up 2 kills in quick fashion. Now look at him moving up to Generator. This is almost a successful site take here, but they might not be able to have enough time. The defuse is going down at the moment here, but look, he's going to peel him off there, and now Wanna Fly, he has not much time left, and he's actually going to have to bug out of this. Myth is able to take this one, and now no time.
Spawned out there by the Cybercam, and that's going to give the cue for Ginny to push out, but looks like Ginny's going to play a little bit safe. The flashpoint does come through. Wanna Fly gets a kill under his New Gen. That's a great start, and he might get a second. Boombarappa though, way too fast for Wanna Fly, as he's going to get the kill, as the flashpoint will secure the exit on the Omen. Looks like they might just go towards B right about now.
Yeah, they're going to TP out there, and I think with the amount of noise made, they're looking for that rotation, but there's only 30 seconds left. They don't have a lot of time. They actually changed their mind, as they do not have the time to really try and make that happen. And with all this, Ginny is going to be able to notice that no one is moving through mid-side. Going to already be moving out towards market. The TP already coming here to try and reinforce. The CTX though is going to be able to take one down. Look at them all trying to push the ledge here. It's not working out. There's only going to be one player left on that side. Poo One Tap going in for the side, but CTX is going to be able to get the 3.
A plan if they can, if they get a couple of guns off the hands of AAA, that's going to be a little bit bonus. As the Aldrin will scout out Congrat, that's gonna signal the push, but Congrat, can he hold on? He gets a kill, but he gets traded as well. PTC through the wall gets double, as well as Ginny getting a kill on this Boombarappa as well. That just leaves only the Breach, and he's not gonna survive.
And come out and go for the peek from that A short.
Yep. Still, they are it looks like they are still trying to go for the B though, despite getting all that information. They do have the Rolling Thunder, which is huge for this side take, and I believe that they will try and use it. CTX, can he come out huge? No, he cannot. New Gen will get a kill, and here comes the Rolling Thunder. Completely whiffs as they're going to try and enter the site without it. distance, gets spotted out there. Genie, can he hold on? Yes, she can. Gets the first kill onto his Boombarappa, and the time is slowly running out. The spike is not down yet as Genie, as well as Wonderfly, all getting kills. PTC gets a kill onto his dealer family, and is down to Mushroom to try and hold on. Out of bullets! PTC will get an E.
Looks like they are going to be hedging their bets. Of course, there is going to be the Owl Drone intel, but looks like Genie with the right shots going to land there from Glass, moving all the way back here as the really doesn't want to get outnumbered here in this fight. Boombarappa moving around Garden, trying to get to the bottom of A ramps, but look at the tight angle here by CDX. He's actually going to get spotted out. So there's not going to be too much of a surprise here for them, but now they are all trapped here. Look at all the angles being set up here by Attack All Around. They are living up to their name at the moment here. Congrat could push in for a tree as well, but look at them. They're all trying to hedge their bets and utilizing at least the cyber cages, but look at this. The CDX going to pick up all of them. Genie from top of ramps here going to also contribute. Getting
Hunter's Fury to really abuse it, but they do have the Rolling Thunder to try and slow things down. Myth already has three ultimates of their own. Here comes the Rolling Thunder, and there's going to be the Lurk or the Flash. No, there's no Lurk. PTC gets a kill onto his new gen, so that's going to give the numbers advantage towards the side of AAA as PTC is going heading towards the side of A. Hunter's Fury trying to clear out the B side. Is going to connect. Is he going to aim for the back of side? No, he's not going to. And that might give Myth a false sense of security that there might be have been a lot of rotations from the side of AAA.
Yeah, we can already see that PTC and Congrat moving over to A. Wannafly also trying
left.
To assist them with the non-existent enemy, but look at this. They're going to be moving in here through the pizza side of things. They are going to find out now after the tripwire is going to be taken down, but with the dark cover going to be in place there, not really going to be able to watch the angle here into market, but they are just going to be saving. They want to save this up for the final round of regulation.
Definitely a very painful save to have. You have four people left alive, but just the time is not working in your favor. Myth, they definitely did not expect to be held up in B main so long, and then towards mid as well. Aftershock used to clear off a couple of angles, but they are not actually in the site yet. PTC walking around with the Vandal Sheet, and they're trying to hold on. Oh, the ultimate from Boombarappa trying to gather information, and they're going to go in, but Congrat, oh, that's a spike down! What a mistake coming from the side. Boombarappa, Congrat gets a second as well. Almost get killed off there by the Blade Storm, but in the end, it's going to be PTC falling. Pull tap, 3v4. The retake scenario is on from the side of AAA. This is for match point. This is for overtime. Can they hold on?
Oh, this is going to be difficult for them. They are not having the numbers advantage here, but look at all the intel that's now being gathered here. Congrat, though, is going to be able to surprise Boo One Tap. There's three players coming here from Tree. Look at this. Acidix is now bringing his own Odin out for his best Sinatra impersonation, but looks like he's still going to mow them down. Looks like the Love Family new gen both are going to die, and he's going to be able to get the defuse. Attack All Around will be taking this first map here.